All right, y'all, so y'all hear that? The beautiful sounds of my truck running. So I never showed y'all, well, as you can see, I got the fender on. The fender's got to come back off, though. I think I'm going to just fix this door. If I start working on it, it becomes too much. I'll buy a door, but I think I'm just going to fix this door. But anyway, this bad boy is running. It has run since the day I got it. I just never said anything or showed anyone. It is a diesel. It's loud, kind of. I mean, you know, it is what it is. It's a 7.3. I'm going to put that down. It's raining in there. It's kind of sprinkling today. But like I said, I got the fender. I got all that put back on. This truck is going to get painted, but I want to recreate the same paint scheme because I actually like it. I know, right? I have all the little stuff left back here that I haven't put on yet. What I was trying to get and find was the header panel. It goes right there. And I'm so crazy. Actually, you know what? How about this? How about I get in the truck and tell y'all, because it's loud out here. All right, so that's a bit better. So as you can see, I kind of got the dash ripped apart. I got the cluster back there, radio, all these radio wires, all this stuff. So when I got this truck, it had no radio. They had cut all the wires out. So and this is what I recommend people do, even though I know people don't do it. I soldered on, well, I have these little quick solder connectors. I soldered this factory plug back on, and this truck has premium sound, which I didn't know was a thing. And I soldered this was the hardest plug to find. I actually had to buy a radio, which the post office destroyed in shipping, but that radio actually still works. It came out of a probe, if anybody knows what a Ford probe is. But the guy had all the wires on the back of it and everything, so I was able to take this plug. And this is the one that I couldn't find. This one you can find aftermarket. And then I have this aftermarket plug here that I wired up to the Sony radio, which is a radio that I had laying around at home, that works perfectly fine. So I soldered up. Y'all quit just cutting plugs off. Buy the plugs. When y'all be riding down the road and eventually that crap vibrates loose and your radio's cutting in and out, that's why. So I made me up a little harness that I can plug into the factory harness. If I ever want to go back with a factory radio, I can do so. Now watch, I did all that work, plugged in this probe radio, because like I said, it still works. The power will come on and everything. It'll change stations, it'll do everything it's supposed to do. No sound. Oh, great. So now I got to read more about premium sound. There's an amp behind the dash. So come to find out, the amp is out. Now I knew something was up in his truck because when I looked under there, the guy had like some speaker wires. Sorry for my fingers. The guy had like some speaker wires running from, he had like nicked the insulation off of wires under there, and he had some speaker wires running to God knows what. I guess he must have had some, like I said, he took all his radio stuff out of here. So he must have had speakers and he may have had an amp. I don't know what all he had in here. But he took all that out, but he just cut and he left those speaker wires. And I was like, why is this here? I think that's why. The amp probably went out a long time ago and he probably was actually just trying to bypass the amp. So upon investigation of all that, my cluster was already looking a fool. It was already really broken up, like, that's normal for these trucks. This is a 95, so like a lot of the points where you're mounted and stuff, all the little pins and stuff was broke off, you know, just different stuff. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna get another cluster. I got another cluster. This is a brand new one. That one, they remake them, which I'm not used to that. Y'all know I have very avant-garde cars and I'm not used to them actually repopping stuff. That's just like the headlight header panel in the front. I'm like, okay, I gotta go to the junkyard and find one. All of them were broken. I'm so stupid. Like, look online, dummy. They probably make those. And guess what? They do. They make them brand new. So, but the reason I haven't put my cluster and stuff back on is because I don't want to be taking it on and off, on and off, on and off. Y'all see what it's doing? Y'all see that? So I have an ICP sensor. That's bad. See, the check engine light was on. You see it's off now, but it's surging like crazy. Let's see. Let's see if I, sometimes I can rev it and get it to smooth out. Other than this ICP issue, it is, see, now it's smoothed out. Like, I don't know what it does, but it's smoothed out and the engine, the check engine light is off. But anyway, it does have the port down there for OBD2. So, I need to get my code reader and probably scan the codes. I'll probably do that today. But anyway, I didn't put the cluster back on because this steering wheel, and like, you can't really tell it, but like when you go to shift it, it just it doesn't feel right. Like, you see what I'm saying? It's the shift thing, and everybody knows that Ford columns of this generation are just, they're trash when it comes to the columns. It's a lot of stuff in them that goes out, the bearings, the bushings, the shift column thingy, all that stuff. So I bought another column that's going in here. That truck only had like 100,000 miles, or maybe like 90 some thousand miles, and I'm gonna take this one out and rebuild it. And also on this, the horn doesn't work, dude. Set up this temporary horn button. Like, I'm not exactly sure what he did. I don't know if he just changed the steering wheel, he changed the whole column or what. I don't know what he did, but the column I got is the full column with the steering wheel and everything. I'll have to reuse the horn pad, but it has cruise and everything. I want all my stuff working. I want the cruise working. I want the horn. I want to be able to press this and the horn actually blows versus reaching down here to press some stupid button. I have the horns unhooked because I did not know. This truck has way more options than I thought. I did not know that this truck has factory keyless entry on it, like the anti-theft. So one day I come in here and I hook this thing up and a light starts flashing and I didn't know what it was. And I looked in the column and it says anti-theft. And I'm like, what? This truck has anti-theft? Because the only keys I got were these keys. This one for the door, this one for the ignition. And also this ignition, like, you see what I'm saying? I shouldn't be able to do that. So I'm getting all new, I'm going to get the lock cylinder and the door so that they all match. And plus, I want this to be chrome instead of black. I don't know, I just like the chrome ones better. Plus, see how the paint is starting to scratch off of it? Just get the chrome so that the paint doesn't scratch off. Because you're going to scratch it with your keys anyway. So, yeah, I'm going to swap out the column, put the cluster back on, you know, so I don't have to come on and off with that all the time. This where he's drilled these holes, and this is the switch. I don't know why he didn't wire the switch for the clearance lights, why he didn't wire them to the park lights, so that when you pull the park lights on, the clearance lights, chicken lights, all that comes on at the same time. No, he put some stupid switch and drilled through this. So now I gotta order one of these. That's like $70. And then he drilled through this. I mean, it's just, why, people, why? Why? Can you try to make your stuff look factory? No. Just men. This is why men shouldn't fool with cars. Watch, I'm going to lose a whole bunch of subscribers behind that. Sorry, guys, but y'all know what y'all be doing, some of y'all. Some of y'all do some good work. Some of y'all, no, indeed. Y'all be doing anything. Y'all don't care how y'all ride. Y'all just be looking crazy. But anyway, so that's some of the stuff I have coming up on the truck. I'm going to try to film some of this stuff. Like I said, I just got in here one day. You can see I got the heat gun. I got radios. I got connectors. I got stuff everywhere. Cluster, trim. That trim was all broke up. I had to buy that trim. I had to buy the trim that goes over here, which I have some really pretty trim for that. But yeah, so, but overall, still a really great truck. Runs and drives good. The power steering is hollering like I don't know what, but y'all know that's a typical Ford thing. So I gotta look and see, is the pump leaking? Are the lines leaking? What is it? I really want to do that before I get too much of that front end put back on. I'm going to come back off with that fender again. There was one mounting place that I need to pull down further. I bought an antenna because in the wreck, whatever sideswiped it, broke the top of the antenna off. So I got another, I actually got a short antenna. So the antenna is actually going to be about that length. It's not going to be a long whip. I really don't like super long whip antennas because you run the risk of breaking them off. If you go through a car wash, I don't really go through car washes because I like washing my own stuff. But you get what I'm saying. You break stuff off. Y'all see it? Back to doing this thistle. But no, overall, great truck. I'm happy with my purchase. There's nothing in there to see. Just owner's manual and stuff. But I'll be happy when I get everything where it's supposed to be. I did get the dash thingy. I need to put the Velcro so that it's stuck down so that it doesn't look so... See how it's all ripply? Because I don't have it stuck down where it's supposed to be. So I need to do that. But I'll be glad. I ordered the amp. The amp's on the way. I haven't seen any videos online about how to put in a Ford Premium Sound amp. I think most people just bypass them. The AC is ice cold. The heat gets nice and warm. Like I said, for $1,800, y'all, a crew cab dually long bed. It is two-wheel drive. It's not four-wheel drive. The white truck over there is four-wheel drive, and so is my Bronco, too. But once again, I really needed a truck. I could have pulled it with the white truck, the 1500, but I really wanted a truck that I could hook up a trailer to, put my car on the trailer, and pull it wherever I need to pull it to. And, you know, I wanted it to be a nice riding truck. I know diesel gas is pretty high right now, but it is what it is. This truck does have dual tanks. I just flipped the tanks. Now my front tank, I can tell you right now, watch what it does. See how it goes all the way past F, bottoms out. It doesn't matter how long I run that tank. I don't know how much is in that tank. My second tank, I usually run it off my second tank because it's actually accurate. When I first got this truck, the second tank was on like 3/4 of a tank. And now it's a little bit below half. You'll see it when it stops. Another thing I have to fix, y'all see the coolant. Ooh, that's cold. I got it on air conditioning. It's cold. Fords are always legendary for freezing you out of here. I love that about Fords. Anyway, because I'm sorry, GM. I don't know what y'all do with y'all air conditioners. They do not be cooling like these Fords. It be icicles hanging. I swear to God, GM, y'all need to do better. But anyway, y'all see the coolant? I mean, the engine temp? See how it's way down there? It never moves. This truck needs a coolant temp sensor. So I will be showing how to put that in. It's really super simple. Oil pressure is good. The batteries are good. I run it every now and again. You can see the mileage. 252,983. Not the best mileage in the world, but it is a diesel. So, you know, it is what it is. You can see. I don't know what happened here. This had tape on it. I don't know if that broke or what. But I don't care. I'm going to change the handles. I want chrome handles. But y'all, as y'all can see, I mean, it's not a dirty truck. It's pretty clean. The headliner is a little faded. But I think I want the lighted... I can't believe this is an XLT and it doesn't have lighted mirrored visors. I think I want that. And I want the roof console that's in the... F-150s. I think I want that in here. So there's some things I want to put in here. Anybody knows me knows I love smoker's windows. Those are my favorite. I have those on my Bronco too. And that's another thing. I want to hurry up and get this put on the road, because after I get this put on the road, I can go get my Bronco too. I can fix the front of it. Y'all know it has collision damage. If you don't know, look back at my old videos. People that love my Broncos, they always comment on different stuff. When am I bringing the Bronco back? It's coming back, y'all. I gotta do one thing at a time. And then I got one more car after that to get back on the road. It runs. I just need to put the exhaust back on. I took the exhaust off for a particular reason. Then I had some issues and with the city and blah, blah, blah. Cities get on my nerves. So I think that's it, y'all. But I just kind of wanted to tell y'all what I had coming up with this truck. Also, maybe does anybody want to know about how to get your stuff back? This truck has a salvage title, so if anybody wants to know how to get your truck back to get the to get it to where it's reconstructed, a rebuilt title, let me know and I'll do a video on that if that's what you want to know. It's different in every state, but it's fairly similar. Oh yeah, I did put a starter in this truck. This truck needed a starter. When I got it, the starter was pretty much dead. Like, you'd hit it and the solenoid wouldn't work. It would just go thunk, thunk. It wouldn't do anything. So yeah, that's all I've done to the truck so far. Luckily, whoever had it before me took care of the windows already, at least the front ones. The rear passenger window is not cooperating. That one's a little slow. I might try to grease it a little to try to get it to last a little longer, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to go in that door and do that one. So yeah, so we got stuff coming up. I have talked y'all to death. So, yeah, till next time. See you guys later.